How's it going, everyone? We're here to check out the skins that made it in this week. And we've got some new permanent item store items, as well as the weekly limited skins. And this week, we have something a little bit different. So we're going to actually go ahead and actually look at the item store itself. And if you go to the general store, you'll see something called the Arctic Pack. It's $12.99, and it comes with a Hazmat skin, a snowmobile skin, and an AK skin. They are permanently bound to your Steam account. You cannot trade or sell these later. Keep that in mind. So here is the Arctic Hazmat suit, and as you can see, this thing is just absolutely amazing looking. The detail put into it, I mean, there's a little GPS, you got the rope with the calipers, you've got the little cobalt logos and so forth, you've got snowshoe adapters, like, it's just really, really nice. And then we'll get up here and take a look at the backpack. Got some more lore here. Peak Sporting Goods. Ah, another company added into Rust lore. So there you go. Just, I mean, amazing details. Ah, there it says Peak again. So there is that. Now, there are some concerns from people about the stats. So if you look here, projectile and melee are the same as the hazmat. But you'll notice bite has actually been reduced from 8 down to 5, radiation protection from 50 to 33, but it has 33 cold protection versus the usual 8, and its explosion has been reduced by 2 as well. So it's been nerfed in bite, rads, and explosion protection, but has a buff to cold. So you won't freeze, but you can't do a full rad run with it, so to say. First up with our deployables this week, we have a stone scientific crate for you guys. That's right. Continuation with this box set, the scientific stone storage will run you $249, and it has everything you would expect to go along with it. Stone drawings and so forth on the blackboard kind of looking top there and sides, as well as a very nice glow, which we'll show you at the end here. Next, for deployables, we've got a wooden single door for you this week. This is the Danger Zone door, and it will run you $249. It does have a really nice glow effect to it with the light right above it, so we'll be sure to show you that at night. And then, of course, with wooden doors, you do have two sides. So there's the opposite side there. Definitely a nice addition to the set. With it being the Arctic update, there had to, of course, be some snowy skins. So we've got a ice garage door for you. This one will run $249 and is, of course, therefore, a little bit more of the expensive side, but is definitely a very unique looking door. Then we've got a armored door for you. It looks like we're getting a few more armored doors here and there, which is always nice. This is the Arctic Base armored door. It'll run you $199. And yeah, it's just got this really nice Arctic camo to it. And it does have an X sign on one side, which some people will definitely enjoy. All right, so there's the glow on the stone box. Very beautiful. Nice kind of light white tone to it, which kind of goes really nice with the stone. And then, of course, we've got the wooden door. Like I said, that light shining down really does look like a light shining down. Definitely great effort done on that. Here's the opposite side. And you would think that the garage door glows, but it does not. So just want to clarify that right here as well. Now, one thing that's new to this is with the spray can being added this update, there's the possibility to reskin things without picking them up, which means large objects can be skinned in the world, and the snowmobile is the first item. As you may have noticed me saying a second ago, that pack came with three things, including a snowmobile skin, right? So let's go ahead and you grab a spray can. These are default to make. And once you click there, you can do the Tomaha skin. And there we go. So there is the Tomaha. So just wanted to kind of show how that works for you guys. Let's go ahead and fly around it for a second here. So you can see it kind of gives it that nice new look to it. Doesn't change anything stat-wise for it. It's not any faster or better or anything like that. There you can see the gauges. Definitely a nice little skin and a very cool thing. We could see hot air balloons, boats, maybe car skins, who knows? I mean, this is the first two very new possibilities. All right, next up with the third piece of this set, you've got a very frosty looking AK. Check this thing out. And if you haven't noticed, there is a frost effect that comes off of it. Yes. Look at that. That is another new thing into Rust. This is the first weapon to have an actual weapons effect. So that is something that is very, very cool. Aiming down the sights here, you can definitely see that ice kind of pouring off of it. And yeah, this is just a really neat addition. And of course, this probably means we'll be seeing stuff like this more often in the permanent item store, I'm assuming. Maybe even in the limited, I don't know. We'll just have to see. But that does it for the Arctic pack. It's going to be this guy, the snowmobile, and the Arctic hazmat suit. Moving on, we've got a couple of regular weapon skins for you, starting out with a continue in the Glistener set with the Glistener Double Barrel. Aiming down the sights here. Lots of rainbow going on. We'll pop a reload for you there. Boom. All set. And there we have it. The Glistener DB can be yours for the usual $199. Next, we've got an MP5 for you, and it is a continuation in the Neo Soul set. This one will also only run you the usual $199, which is awesome. And this has been a pretty good start to a set. I mean, this is a third piece now, and it's selling quite well, so it might be a smart one to pick up. Aiming down the sights here, you've got a mix of the aqua versus dark colors there. And let's go ahead and do that reload for you. And last but not least, we've got an L9 for you, and this is the Polar Bear L96. This will also only run you the usual $199. It's got this really cool polar bear art on the side, and then the whole thing just has kind of a very frosted Arctic look to it, which is quite nice. You can even see there on the slide, the ball looks like the new radar tower, right there, which is quite cool. So there we have it, everyone. That is the new stuff for this week. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to sound off down in the comment section below which ones you picked up and why, and are you picking up the Arctic pack? I know I definitely am, because I am definitely one of those skin collectors, and I have to own the first vehicle skin. So yeah, everyone sound off how you feel about that. Stay rusty, and thanks for watching.